the meeting in order from the executive closed session. I have a motion to close the executive session and open our special meeting. I have a motion, I have a second. Second, it's okay, good. Roll call. Hold up, say aye. All in favor?
Aye.
Good, let's continue. We don't have, why don't you go ahead about this?
Mr. Mayor, I'd like to make a motion to put a resolution on the folks to keep Chief where he is and the captain where he is.
Second. Let's go ahead.
Thank you, Mayor. So after executive session where there was discussion, I'll ask the Councilman Petrie to confirm, but I believe that the motion he's proposing is a motion to ratify those actions that were taken at the December 22nd, 2022 meeting and that were recently invalidated by the Superior Court. Specifically, the actions are approving Anthony Espino as Chief of Police, Resolution 2022-293, approving a contract for Anthony Espino as Chief of Police, Resolution 2022-294, approving a settlement agreement or release for Anthony Espino, and approving John Gasparovich as Captain of the Palisades Police Department. As background, the governing body initiated litigation in Superior Court, asking a judge to make a determination whether the actions that were taken on December 22nd were valid, because they were adopted on a 2-0-1 vote, in which two council members voted yes and one council member was recused. After the litigation was heard, the judge issued a decision last week which held that 3 affirmative votes were required for the actions to be taken, and as a result, she declared them void ab initio, which means that they were void from the moment that they were reportedly adopted. The resolution that's put forward by the councilman just before would ratify those actions, and if they were adopted tonight with a sufficient number of votes, would allow for them to take effect as if they were approved validly in the first instance. As the public is aware, the litigation was initiated in order to address the procedural infirmities that occurred and to seek confirmation from the court whether the vote that was taken with only 2 yes votes was in fact correct. I don't want to speak any further for the council members, but Councilman Petrie, is that an accurate depiction of the motion you're looking to make?
Yes, it is.
So in other words, Father McClure, in plain simple English, you would like to, after the municipality of Palisades Park won the case concerning unlawful promotions, there are right now a motion on the table, on the floor, that is recommending from the council members to be in effect on a vote saying that we will, after the court case was over, the council member is considering to reinstate their position after it has been found that it is unlawful. Is that correct?
Yes. Actually, we made a very good decision, but because
we didn't make a decision yet.
No. Last year.
Last
December. I believe we made a very good decision because we went through the interviews and we went through all the records and each person's ability to carry out their position. And but because 2 votes on important matter is not valid, that's what we learned. But the same respect and same trust on the decision was made in very good faith. So I'm so happy to put this on
that. Okay, go ahead.
Council,
yes, absolutely, go ahead.
During the course of the litigation between the captain and the chief, it was really, when we filed an appeal, it really wasn't going after the chief or the captain. It was going to the process the way it was done. And so that in the future that someone else or a couple of councilmen want to promote someone like that would have to be with 4 people, just following the rule. Nothing personal against these 2 gentlemen.
Very good. Councilman Kim?
Yeah, I just echo with Councilman Petrie, and also I add that we are talking about respect to our captain and the chief, all the work he's been done. So, mistake or all those things, that is not their fault. They deserve what they've been doing, and they've been doing a good job as well. So we're talking about the respect to them, so I'm going for the stay as it is, and demoting or any other nonsense.
Anybody else want to have 2 cents of court?
Mayor, just one legal item. I heard a reference to 4 votes. I just want to make clear the judge's decision was that based upon 48:60-3, there's a provision that says that a personnel appointment can't be made without 3 affirmative votes, and she based her decision upon that. So the statute says, and your borough ordinance follows that statute, and says that 3 affirmative votes are required for the appointment of officers. The officers is more of an official of the borough, not the title and police ranking. So 3 affirmative votes was the standard.
But if that's the case, it's about hiring jobs. If I'm correct, concerning the job or the position, the council members would suggest or recommend, as we did before, it will come to the mayor, and is it the mayor's choice to put it into the agenda, into the resolution or not? Concerning jobs.
You are correct, Mayor, that the, and we did discuss this, we can certainly discuss this further in closed session.
Yes.
The mayor typically has the nominating power. However, when a position is vacant for more than 30 days, that rests with the council.
Right.
Based upon the judge's decision and the appointments being void ab initio, that means that the positions have been vacant for over 30 days since they've been vacant since December 22nd, essentially, based upon her decision. So now that where we are in the calendar, in July, the positions have been vacant over 30 days such that the council can act.
But then we weren't decided until what 30 days were until the judge's decision.
That is true, Mayor. The decision was based upon the situation at that point.
So I understand your point of view, but the other side of the coin is that because the decision was made, we could stipulate that it's 30 days from there on as well, correct?
I'm not in a position here, Mayor, to offer a legal dissertation. If you want to go back into closed session to talk about that specifically, I'd be happy to.
Okay, so this is something maybe we could, I don't know. Do you guys want to make a decision now? Or you want to do another closed session? But then there's a motion on the table, but we got to figure out who has to present that. You're telling me, would you please? You can have your
Don't start with that.
Okay,
I'm telling
please,
you that.
Let me just finish it.
I'm going to tell you,
please. You can tell me
with
what?
The word, please.
Okay, anyways. I want to figure this out correctly by law. Do I, as a mayor, have to present this or not, or can we just go in like you said, is that 30 days or something?
There's a motion and a second on the table, Mayor, so if your question is whether there needs to be a vote on it, my position would be yes under Robert's rules, if there's a proper motion.
Concerning even though a job that I'm supposed to recommend to the council, the 30 days after, is that okay?
As I said, based upon the timeline and the fact that under the judge's decision, the position's been vacant for 7 months. That the council statutorily has the power to act after a vacancy in excess of 30 days.
And even though we found out results just now, recently, it's already been passed, correct?
That would be fine.
All right, good. That's all I wanted to know. All right, so we have a motion on the table.
Jane.
Yes.
Kim.
Yes.
Min.
I want to say the one thing before I vote. When the action was taken, I was not a position of the council. So I want to abstain on this vote.
Abstain. Well, there's 2 types, recuse and abstain. Recuse is when you're a common interest, correct?
Correct.
So you're abstaining. Thank you.
Hart.
Yes.
Sadly, I have to recuse myself. Petrie.
Yes.
Good.
Motion passes.
Good. All right. Anything else?
I invited the expert tonight. I'd like to actually, Ms. Carroll over there, sorry if you wait, but I'd like to actually just to recommend her to submit an official proposal, so we could actually over.
Yes.
Right now.
No.
So, Ms. Carroll, would you kindly send us your proposal with the breakdown of the scope of work to all the councilors here tonight? The email should be on the website. So, please, would you do that for me?
As fast as you can, thank you. Anything else? How about you?
No, I'm sorry.
How's the head? Nothing, how about you?
No, I'm not.
You sure?
That is. It was very nice tonight, though, I think, on my outside. Very nice, yeah, on my outside.
Good, good. Councilman Kim.
I think the report.
Councilman Petrie.
I'm here in the meeting. Please have a, find out who is available for the.
We did. We tried our best as we can. Councilman Petrie, we meet council Monday. We're supposed to meet Monday. Two people had a conflict. I want to be the majority of the people. We can't sometimes make everybody all come, but I'm glad that you guys are here. Councilman Petrie.
I'll report again next week.
Thank you. Councilman Mark.
No reasons.
Good. Have a motion to close, have a motion to open to the public.
Motion.
Second.
Second.
Favor?
Aye. Motion to the public. Any questions? Yes. You can speak great if you want to.
My order says 110 is the area.
130?
110 is the area.
110. Speak over there, so we can hear them.
110 is Harriet Avenue.
I sent to email the,
January 27.
Send it to, I can't speak English.
Or speaking.
Ma'am, could you can speak Korean? I'll try my best.
10월 27일 날, 이메일을 전부 보내드렸어요.
See, we received our email on January, what's it? July 27.
네, 다 보내드렸거든요.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
트러블, 문제점이, 괜히, dangerous, next, 108 East Harriet.
What's the address again?
108.
108 East Harriet.
East Harriet.
This is a neighbor of yours, please go ahead.
Yeah. 거기가 옆집입니다.
Go ahead, we got, he's a neighbor, yeah.
Yeah. 근데, 주차장을 불법으로 했고.
Seeing that there is a legal parking made within the premises, go ahead.
또 방도 여러 개 들여서, 그것도 불법으로 했고.
She suspects that there's a legal residence living there with multiple, families in the one family home.
그리고, 밤 근무하는 사람, 야간 근무하는 사람, 낮에 근무하는 사람, 교대로 하면서 한, 30명 살고 있어.
She concerns about 23 people living in and out of that house.
그리고 또, 아기를 맡기고 와요.
Seems like there are people dropping off their kids and hang around and do like a daycare program.
그래서 막, 또일요일이나 토요일마다 파티를하고, 그래서,
There's noise, noise issues, party issues, what do we get?
그런데 지금, 쓰레기도 전부 날라오고.
You're saying there's complaints with throwing garbage?
그거는 그나마 또, 뭐, 가지겠는데, 주차장을 불법으로 해서, 이게, 저희가 서비스 측량을 할 때, 꽂아놓은 스탠드, 그 말뚝이 너무 주차, 차를 세우면서 넘어와가지고 부러졌어요.
So they did a survey of your property, there's some states there, they busted out because a parking issue, cars parked, like, for example, where the green area is, grass, yeah, come on.
그리고 우리 성자들이랑 놀러 오면 그 잔디밭에서 뛰어 떼게야 돼. 뛰어 놀아야
되는데.
그거 차가 넘어와서 그 스탠 말뚝이 부러졌는데
okay.
너무나 무섭고
okay.
위험해요.
I want to ask you a question. 네. Okay, I'll speak bilingual. What have you done so far? Because I remember this counselor, what happened was I actually talked to our prosecutor,
okay.
saying that what happened, I went to the building department. I went to the building department, what's going on? It seems like they're not paying our codes, they're just not complying. So right now we're up to the stage with our prosecutor. I called Carter, our prosecutor, to find out what's going on. He said it's in the files. And this has been, I asked that maybe 2 months ago.
I mean, I think, Mayor, if there have been tickets issued, then the prosecutor would have the ability to prosecute those. If tickets haven't been issued, or if there's still ongoing issues, and certainly with the information that the commenter is making, I would definitely refer this to code enforcement so that they can look at it.
And code enforcement stated that they couldn't handle, they didn't respond to the tickets, that I in compliance.
Oh, I see.
So they gave it to the prosecutor's office, and Carter, we 검사가요.
네.
The prosecutor's office, Carter, Mr. Carter said that he's working on it, that case. 그러니까 검사가 그걸 보고 티켓을 줬는데 계속 돈도 안 되고 그래서 검사가 지금 그거를 코트에 데리고 하려고 하고 있다고 그랬어요. So the prosecutor said that, you know, because he didn't comply with the tickets, paying the tickets, he's have to handle that. What I could do for you is tomorrow I can call Carter, the prosecutor, 검사한테 연락을 해서 tomorrow, and ask what's up with that case, and I'll get back to you. Is that okay? 내가 내일 검사한테 연락을 해서요, 그 케이스에서 네가 그거 한다는 점에서 어떻게 됐냐, 그거를 내가 알고 내가 이메일 보내드리겠습니다, 정식이.
예, 예, 감사합니다. 저는 첫째는 주차장 패스했으면 좋겠습니다.
알겠습니다.
두 번째는 펜스를 그러면 이중으로라도 철망으로 하든가 철망으로 하고 또
So she's saying that, you know, immediate action should be, you know, to fence that area, just dangerous for kids, and they should not allow cars being parked in the green areas. That's not authorized as a parking space. 감사합니다.
네,
카라한테 검사한테 물어보고 내가 그 연락 드리겠습니다.
네.
I will contact you personally after I talk to the prosecutor.
네, 감사합니다.
I'll get back to you. Thank you very much. Anybody else? Well, you guys, that's it? All right, good. We have a motion to close public administration. Can I have a second? Good.
All in
favor?
Aye.
All right. We have a motion to close and adjourn the meeting today.
Motion.
Can I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you very much.